Now, so you get your ad out, okay? You're renting your apartment for rent, whatever it is, one bedroom, two bedroom, three bedroom, or a single family home, whatever the case is. And you start getting calls. This is where the rubber meets the road. This is probably, this whole process I'm describing in this series of videos is absolutely the most important thing you can ever be concerned with when it comes to managing rentals, okay? So there's multiple parts to the screening process. The first part is the telephone call itself, okay? Because in your ad, you're not gonna give them the address or the location you're renting. You're gonna give them enough benefits for them to call you, enough features to help screen them out, because let's face it, somebody wanting a one bedroom apartment is not interested in a three bedroom apartment, and vice versa. So make sure you put those features in there to be a little bit of a screening process. Now back to the part when they actually do call you. We first go through what's called a telephone interview, okay? Telephone interview process, and there's a form you use to actually screen them, okay? There's a it looks like an application because it's actually based on the application. And on that form, you start filling out the blocks, or the boxes. So they call you up. Oh, by the way, always have them call a number with a pre-recorded message and a way to leave an answer, a message to you. It's an answer machine, basically. It's all electronic now. And what you're doing is another screening process, okay? Use every step of the communication cycle as a screening process. So when someone responds to your ad, they get a quick recording, they get to leave a message, okay? And then you can pull out your telephone questionnaire. You first put in there up top the name and phone number, because they would have given you their name and their phone number. Then you call them up and you start asking all the, first you build rapport, and then you start asking the questions. Well, how many bedrooms do you need? You don't ask them how many children they have, ask them how many bedrooms do you need, okay? And you wanna determine, ask them, how long have you lived where you're currently living? How long have you worked where you're currently working? And get all that information on the telephone questionnaire, okay? So what we're doing is we're looking for a good track record of tenantship. That, you know, how long have they lived there? It's important that they live there for at least a year. I like to look for people living somewhere 3 years or more. Because that leads me to other questions. Well, why is it that you're looking to leave? Why are you going to pull your kids out of school? Why are you going to be further away from where you work now? Ask them, you know, where do they work, okay? How long have they worked there? All that information. And you put that in your telephone questionnaire, okay? So that's the next thing, and you keep that with you. All this stuff gets recorded and filed. You're going to be the master of documentation, okay? You have to be, okay? That's one of the most important things I could ever teach you is, you've got to keep good records, keep track of everything, make note of date, time, and length of conversation, everything, okay? So next video is I'm going to tell you what to do. By the way, once you've finished the telephone interview, assuming that you and they both believe that this place could be a good fit for them, then you give them the address and have them do a drive-by, okay? Assuming these are all tests, these are all commitment tests. Assuming you do the drive-by, they call you back and they say, yes, we definitely want to see that place. Then you set up your appointment. That's what we'll get over next. So look for the next video. In the meantime, take care, and God bless you and your families.